Let's first understand how the login process works. You walk up to a workstation and you log in. And how do you log in? Well, you log in using your username and password. And this login process is special that runs on the Virtu workstation. It communicates with the login server that is inside the Vice by presenting the username and password in a secure fashion. We'll see how that is done in a bit. So it presents the username and password securely over the insecure links to the login server. And the login server, once it authenticates who you are using the username and password, it is going to send you a pair of tokens. And remember, all of this is happening on behalf of the user by the smarts in the virtual workstation. The user has to do nothing special. All that the user is doing is logging in using a username and password. Under the covers, these things are happening. First, the login process communicates securely with the login server, presenting the username and password. And the login server then returns two tokens. One is called a secret token, the other is called a clear token. The clear token is a data structure. Once again, I have to mention that both the secret and clear tokens are communicated back to the login process by the login server in a secure manner over the insecure links. We'll see how that is done in a minute. So once the login process gets these two tokens, decrypts them and gets these two tokens, the login process decrypts the message that contains these two tokens and extracts the clear token and the secret token. The clear token is really a data structure which is known to the login process. And the data structure in particular contains a handshake key. We'll call it HKC. So from this clear token data structure, the login process can extract this handshake key. And the secret token is just a bit string so far as the login process is concerned. The way it is generated by this login server is to encrypt this clear token with a key known only to Vice. It's not the same as HKC. It is a key that is known only to Vice to encrypt the clear token. And we will see how this key is going to be used later on. So to recap, Virtu sends securely the username and password to the login server. Login server securely sends secret token and clear token back to this login process. From the clear token, the login process extracts the handshake key. And the secret token is basically a bit string, which is an encryption of the contents of this clear token, encrypted with a key that is known only to Vice. In other words, the secret token is unique for this login session, and it is a bit string, which means nothing to anybody that sees it on the wire. And therefore, we can use this bit string that secret token represents as the ephemeral client ID for this login session. Recall I said we don't want to expose the username and password too often on the wire. This is Andrew's answer to dealing with that problem by providing an ephemeral client ID for this login session. Once a user is logged in, they get an ephemeral client ID, which is the secret token. And this can be used in the future communication between Virtu and Vice as the client ID. Now, how will Vice know who is communicating with it when it sees this bit pattern? Remember that this bit pattern, secret token, is an encryption of the clear token, and the key for decrypting it is known only to Vice. So when the secret token comes as the client ID, Vice can decrypt it and find out from that what is the clear token associated with that particular bit string which is representing the secret token. And once it knows that, it can also extract the handshake key that it gave to a particular client. And that's how the identity of the client that is communicating with the Vice in the future, presenting this secret token as the ephemeral client ID, can be recognized by Vice. So now, after the login is done, for all the future communication between Venus and Vice, HKC can be used as a private key for establishing a new RPC session. This pair of tokens, the secret token and clear token, is stored on the Virtue workstation by Venus on behalf of this user for the entire login session. At the end of this login session, these two tokens will be thrown away by Venus. But during the login session, these two tokens are representing this particular user that has logged in. And so for the duration of this login session, Venus will use the secret token, which is a bit string that represents this particular user for this login session, as the client ID to send information over to the Vice. And any information that Venus sends to Vice to establish an RPC session is going to be encoded with the private key that it has been handed now through the clear token data structure. That is the handshake key that has been given as part of this login exchange through the clear token data structure. At the core of the entire secure RPC system of the Andrew file system is the bind mechanism for setting up a client-server connection securely. And that's what we're going to look at next.